So the transformation journey. So now I want to talk about how we did it, right? And what has been the different steps with SIA. So first thing first, well, we use in Y a very classical operational excellence type of framework, right? When you do transformation, you have a three dimension people and culture. So here we talk about skills, we talk about mindset, we talk about management style, really everything related to soft thing, okay? Then you have the practices and the tools. So here, the frameworks, Kanban and this and TD and BDD and design thinking and build, test, learn, whatever, all right? So that's really the different practices or tools you're gonna use. And then there is everything related to structure and system, really structure of the organization itself, but also structure of the IT landscape, but also different tools that you need to manage portfolio, to manage innovation, to manage software delivery. So, and in the middle, you have this change management process and organization. So at Y, we have been doing that for many years, right? The name was created in 2014, but our activities go back to 2005 and 6. So it's been quite a few years that we are working on this topic of transformation and agile for large companies. And we have defined our own kind of framework, right, where we engage in this change and transformation. So typically what we start doing usually is what we call a scan. So that's kind of a deep dive into the organization, the current status, understanding the goals, understanding the business objective, understanding how they work now, and also why they work like this. Because, you know, in companies, there is always a good reason why we are working in a certain way. So before you break it, you better understand well why they are working in a certain way. I'm also always very worried when I see consultants and so on starting to break the company or the organization without really understanding why it was working in a certain way. We can get into big troubles. So scan and plan, all right? So then we take the top management, we bring them into a workshop, and we do the transformation plan. And then we are going to create a backlog of change, okay? A change backlog, which is the change transformation program backlog. And then obviously we are going to incrementally deliver changes in the company in the most possible smooth way. So I don't believe in a disruptive transformation. You can do it on a small scale for some areas where the risk is acceptable, but at scale, I don't think a disruptive approach is possible, especially for large organizations that are usually very, very risk adverse. So this is what we call an agile scan. So we have our own framework of organizational capability for agile. All right, and what we do is that we go with a few consultants. It can last maybe 2 weeks for a small setup of 200 people or 300, and it can last 1 month or even sometimes two when we talk about very large companies. And then after that, we are going to bring a set of problems, difficulties, and also a set of recommendations. We take the top management, the C-level guys, into a strategic workshop where we discuss that. This workshop, same. For a small setup, we are talking about 1 day. For a very big setup, we can talk about 2-3 days. And then based on that, we are going to come with a transformation roadmap. Okay, so again, an agile scan. So at ITD, so in SIA, we came up with different key problems that were identified, right? And then we came up with a few recommendations. So I'm sorry, this data is confidential, so I cannot share. But we came up with a few recommendations. I have some examples I can show you, but we took everybody in a workshop with the management, and we started to think about, okay, how can we prioritize, you know, very classical cost benefit analysis for the transformation roadmap, identifying changes and then taking people, analyzing what change are the most valuable, what change are the most expensive, and start to prioritize our transformation based on this. So maybe we're gonna start with one department on these things, and then once we are good, we will extend to this other department and we'll increase the maturity level and so on and so forth. Something staged, if you wish, by step, right? We do the transformation by successive steps. So we came up with a vision, right? This is what the digital department came up with, a vision for the transformation. So the objective of the transformation, right, is to have frequent releases. It's to always prioritize test and learn, right? So really this iterative build, test, learn loop, collaboration, cross-functional team, involvement of the business, empowerment in decentralization of decision, and value-driven. I'd like to stress here that this might look like standard type of agile stuff, but again, in a company like Singapore Airlines, that is a pretty traditional organization, when you say that you want to empower teams to make decisions, it's a big shift, right? It means that we're going to change our management style. So all this was very strongly defined and supported by all the level of the organization, including CEO, right? So we clearly got a mandate. So we got the top management to say, we agree with this and you go for it. And then we had a roadmap. You see, as you can see here, the idea is to be progressive in the way we do the transformation. So we are going to work through different level of maturity. So, okay, we had to make a bit of preparation work here, right? And then focus on a subset of the squads. We started with only 15 squads, right? And we, some of them had IT subcontractors. So it was still very IT oriented. The idea behind this was to say, first, we need to make the IT clean, if you want. First, we need to IT people to really understand the delivery machine, right? And to do it well, to deliver. Remember, be agile, do agile. First, a bit of do agile, delivery focus. Then the second stage has been to engage much more the business. And here we have started to really work on POs, business, road mapping, outcome-driven roadmap, introduction of OKR to measure outcomes, and so on. Okay, so first we involve the business, right? We also worked on support function, budgeting, HR, all these kind of things, right? To really start to make it smooth. And then the last steps of the transformation was really centered on outcome, delivering outcome, right? So measuring outcome, putting in place the governance model that I have mentioned before, and really getting our manager to drive the company through outcome measurement, data-driven outcome measurement. And yeah, we did it. So that's also one thing that I have found very spectacular with SIA. It's the capability to execute the plan. That was the plan. And of course, there have been some adjustments in terms of time, in terms of scope, but we did it. Yeah, very impressive. So the whole transformation is based on waves. Okay, so what we do is that it's a sequence of waves. Actually, it's not really a sequence because each wave is 6 months, right? Each wave is embarking a set of squads, right? It's a domain or even multi-domain. It's a set of squads, and each wave lasts 6 months, and we start a wave every 3 months, right? So we have another lap of two waves at each time. And this is because at the beginning of a wave, when we start the squad, there is a lot of work to do in order to mentor the squads. And after 3 months, they become to be a bit better, more independent, and therefore we can free a little bit of bandwidth of the coaches, right? So the way we manage the transformation, every 3 months, tactical plan, right? So we have a roadmap on 2 years, 2 years and a half. Every 3 months, we plan the detailed tactical plan for the next 3 months. So that becomes kind of a backlog, if you wish. We have a backlog for the whole transformation, but that becomes a bit of a more detailed backlog. So here you see a Trello board. Actually, after the first wave, everything moved into Jira, including the transformation. Jira was the company tool for everything Agile. There has been an enablement team created inside the SIA. And remember my 3% stuff? This team of enablement is led by a transformation lead. His name is Hao Yu, a very good guy who knows SIA in and out, very well connected everywhere. And with him, 20 people. Right? The team, the transformation team is 20 people. It's not two guys here and there. 10 to 12 coaches, plus people for the tools, plus people for this, that. It's a, well, very well structured program. So a lot of focus on the mindset, of course, a lot of focus on management, and also a very structured change management approach by SIA. So people explaining to people what is the impact for them, job description, changes of responsibilities, communication, training, awareness at all level. Very structured approach to the transformation. Right? A lot of effort put in people understanding what SIA is trying to do. And that also was pretty amazing. It's very linked to SIA culture. SIA culture, I should have said that maybe a bit at the beginning, but it's a very friendly, harmonious kind of culture. You know, the culture of SIA is service and empathy for customers, so care. And you can feel it when you work in this company. You know, you have all these attendants and so on. They are very used to be very nice, to smile, to be very caring, and it creates an atmosphere that is very, very special. So of course, as I mentioned at the beginning, we have done a lot of training. I don't have exactly the figures, but I would say probably 100 to 200 days of training delivered in SIA, right, in total. And really, as I mentioned before, a structured approach to mentoring, coaching, transferring the know-how, right? Here I'm more talking about do agile, really helping the teams to adopt agile ways of working, maturity radar, to help the coaches to adopt and to align with their team on what to focus on. As I mentioned before, Jira became the overall tool for portfolio management. We have been using the portfolio plugin of Jira. At that time, we didn't have Jira Align yet, but maybe would be a possible extension, right? And for finance, we use a different tool for the budgeting, but that's a detail. Okay, this I think is pretty classical, right? So each coach will perform regular assessment of the level of adoption of a practice against the framework on a regular basis, all right? Usually about every month, every two sprints. We will run that with the team, right? So it's not an external assessment. It's more collaboratively between the coach and the team. We are assessing this. And I will come back on this because that's how we measure the organizational maturity index. Leadership program, a lot of session, 250 middle managers, right? So head of departments, head of team, and so on, were engaged into an agile leadership program. Combining courses and coaching, right? And now I'm talking coaching, not mentoring, but really coaching with these people, 10 sessions of coaching, right, at leadership level. This is a picture of what we did on the strategic planning, right? So remember what I mentioned before, we have changed completely the way business and technology work together. So now what we do is that every year, usually before that, the business will come with a strategy, they will define projects, and they will specify project, and then they will get to the IT to dimension product, give a number, right? Like project-based, right? And then they will add all the numbers, and then they try to negotiate. This process used to take months, right? 2 to 3 months to align IT and business on the next year of planning. And then, of course, this planning in the past was very difficult to change because it's been budgeted and so on, very complicated. Now what we do is that in a 2 days workshop, we bring business and IT together and we get all the initiative prepared by business, but at very one pager, just the main objective, we call it an initiative canvas. And then we bring what you see in the here, right? It's the different initiative canvas. And then we go through a cost-benefit analysis, so benefit by the business and cost by the tech guys, and prioritization of the initiatives. And at the end of this workshop, we come with a set of measurements for the initiative outcomes. So very different ways of working. At the beginning, everybody was a bit surprised. And very quickly, actually, people find it very interesting and very fast. Then once we were more in the do agile and delivery was well done, we started to move into really product management and then after product management innovation. So this is the key for success, the key to success concept of Singapore Airlines, where you see from business idea down to delivery, right? The whole process that mixing design thinking, lean startup, agile frameworks, to really deliver faster business outcome. And here, what you see below are different structure, okay? This is the delivery center. This is more the tech guys, right? And these two things are more the design thinking and business innovation labs, if you wish. What the first quadrant you see here on the top left is really the burn up of business value. So it's really a measure of how much business value a given product or team is delivering. So we institutionalized, so we made this kind of dashboard like a standard across all the team and product. Okay, the rest I'm just gonna go browsing a few things just to give you an idea of things, right? So we have obviously a knowledge management system in which we capture everything that is related to Agile, right? We have everything in Jira. The whole transformation program itself is in Jira, and we are tracking everything. And as I mentioned before, we had an initial one only indicator to measure the progress of a transformation, not the outcome, the progress, right? And this only indicator was the maturity index, which is computed by bringing all together the different assessments, you know, via radar, this one. Okay, so for each team we do this, and at the end of that, we can come up with one index that we measure at regular points. And so this shows the adoption of agile practice from the framework across the whole SLA. Okay, just a few things that I wanted to kind of use for concluding this talk. I think when we talk about agile and agile adoption, I think there is a need to look at culture. Agile is a change of culture. It's a change of DNA. It's a change of culture. And I think it's very important to realize that the way agile is going to be adopted in a given part of the world, Asia versus Western, but also in different companies, is going to be different. And it's going to leverage different aspects of the company culture itself. So you see, when I look at sometimes I hear people saying that self-organization is difficult in Asia, or in Asia, we have a lot of respect for hierarchy, and there it's a blocker to agile. Well, I just would like to say one thing about this kind of stuff is the Agile Manifesto, which is for me the fundamental basis of Agile, does not talk about these things, right? Okay, it talks about collaboration. It doesn't say how. So I think when you observe what's going on in Asia, I see a lot of agility. I see a lot of agile mindset, actually, and a lot of capability to build, test, learn. And I think there is also a lot of agility in the culture itself. So with regards to culture, in SIA, we have done a lot of workshop on communities of practice, teaching people, sharing knowledge. We had clinics where people come, it's a free open sessions, people come with problems that they are facing. And we have a bunch of coaches that are helping to solve these problems straight away, live in the room, right? We had events like Agile Beers. I don't know if you know this concept, right? So sometimes it's kind of meetup. So it's an internal meetup. This one is internal to SIA. Every month we gather around some drinks and enjoy discussion, very informal, good fun. One important thing as well that I need to mention is that we did a lot of work. So there is a lot of contractors in SIA. So in the tech department, out of 1,200, at least 600 or 700 people are contractors. We went to India to train people, to communicate with them. All the squads that I was mentioning, they are not SIA squad versus Indian squads or whatever. They are mixed, right? In each squad, we have the contractors and the SIA people. They are one squad. So they have one big partner. We went in India and worked a lot with these guys. Okay, just giving you a couple of results that SIA has measured. One of the most probably spectacular one was the cadence of a delivery of product and new product that was increased by 60%. So in terms of average release frequency of product. Well, Singapore Airlines did its best ever year in 2018 and 19 in the year of assessment. Well, I'm afraid that this year is going to be a terrible year, but I don't think it's linked to the transformation. They also assessed that their staff, pilots, crew member, and so on get much better timely information about their work and find it very useful. And one measure, so that's a measure I like a lot. It's also the same measure that we used in DBS. The whole transformation outcome is measured in terms of hours saved. Right, so hours saved by the customer to book a ticket, hours saved by customers in the lounge, hours saved for employee to prepare their stuff, hours saved by pilots to prepare the routes, and so on and so forth. Everything is estimated in terms of hours saved. Right, so I found this very, very agile way of measuring outcome. Very interesting metric. Okay,